Okay, question. What's the most important difference between editing photos and editing videos? No? Well, let's say you're a beginner and you're like, okay, I know Photoshop, so how hard can it really be to edit a video in DaVinci Resolve? Let me just change the color of my t-shirt, for example. There, looks okay, right? But now, not so much. And that's the big difference. A video is a moving picture. Duh. So you're also gonna have to learn how to make your edits move with the picture. And that's what I'm gonna show you today. A few basic techniques in DaVinci Resolve that you should start practicing if you're a beginner. And most of these techniques also work in a free version, by the way. Here we go. And the first technique is using windows. So let's go to the color page and add a window here. And a window is basically a selection that you make, right? Could be circular, gradient, square, or even a custom shape. And then you can adjust the colors inside that window or hit this button here and invert it. See? But of course, if you add a window just like that, it's static, it doesn't move. So now let's use some of Resolve's tracking features to make that window move, to make it follow an object or a face or whatever. So in the color page, create a window here, and then let's change the exposure, for example. And if you hit Shift plus H, it will show you the actual mask, see? Then go to the tracking tab and make sure to set it to window here. And down here, set it to point tracker. Or for Resolve Studio users, you can also use the IntelliTracker. Then hit this button here so you get the tracking symbol, that plus sign, and put it over whatever it is you want to track. For example, the logo on my hat here. Hit track, and I'm going to use track forward and reverse now because my playhead is in the middle of the clip. See? And now the window will follow the movement of the logo. That's it. And you can still move the window, but it will keep following the movement of the logo on my hat. But now the problem is that the window only follows the movement. It won't change shape or size. For example, if you make a window for an object that moves closer to the camera, it should also get bigger because the object also gets bigger relative to the frame, right? So now let's take that technique to the next level. I don't know if you can see it, but it's so incredibly hot in my studio today. I don't even want to talk about it. Let's just move on. Two examples. First one, let's make a window to make my face a bit more yellow, for example, just to show you an example, right? Or let's make it a lot more yellow so that you can actually clearly see what's happening. Like that. Then go to the tracking tab here and make sure it's set to window. And this to cloud tracker. And then just hit track and see. Resolve will actually track my face, and based on that tracking information, not only will the window follow the movement of my face, but it will also change the shape of the window, the perspective. Okay, a second example. Let's use a custom shaped window, right? This couch, for example. Let me make a custom window real quick to show you. It's not very accurate, but it's just to show you how it works. There. So the window, when I play the clip, see, the window should not only follow the couch, but also get bigger the closer the couch is to the camera. See? And again, it's super easy. Just hit track with the cloud tracker and boom, the window will now follow the shape and the size of the couch. So that's the first technique, windows. This is actually an easier technique, or I mean, maybe not. It depends. Let me just show you and then you decide. So again, we're in the color page, but now go to the qualifier tab here. And this tool allows you to pick a color or a color range or a tone range, and then you can adjust those colors. So just click on a color or a color range. For example, skin tones, click on the face and then hit Shift plus H so you can see the selection or the mask. And if you want to add to the selection, use the dropper tool with the plus sign here. See? And just keep clicking. But you can also use the sliders down here to refine your selection based on hue, so color, saturation, or luminance. For example, if I want to get rid of my beard in the selection, I can drag the luminance slider so that it excludes the darker parts. And then you have even more settings here. I'm not going to go over all of them in detail now. The most important one, in my opinion, is denoise, which will soften the edges of the selection or the mask. But see, you don't have to use any tracking or anything because the selection is based on tones, colors. So it will just move with the colors in your picture, in your video. But what if, for example, you want to adjust the skin tones, right? And you make a selection or you make a mask of the skin tones, But that mask also includes some tones, some colors in the background, and you don't want to adjust those colors in the background. Then what? Well, I'll show you how to do that with the next technique. But first, let's talk about something else besides color grading that will also take your videos to the next level, and that's motion graphics. And I get my motion graphics from MotionVFX, the sponsor of this video. Literally every single video that I've made in the last 2 years has an effect, a title, or an animation from MotionVFX in it. And if I have to name something you should get first, it's some animated titles. An animated title will instantly improve your videos and make them look more professional. But also, if you're looking for something more specific, MotionVFX has you covered. The M Storytelling Toolkit, for example, or the M Science Toolkit. And these toolkits have everything you need to make your videos look next level. And even if you're a complete beginner, you will get great results because everything is super easy to use, just drag and drop. That's it. So go check them out and use my link in the description. And of course, thank you so much, MotionVFX, for supporting my channel. Okay, now back to color grading. I'm slowly dying here, but I mean, I have to keep going, right? Look at this. I don't know if you can see that. I'm literally wet. Here. What is this nonsense? My God. I should have recorded this video at like 3 in the morning. Okay, let's move on. Okay, so now let's combine the qualifier with windows. See, in this example, I have selected skin tones with the qualifier, but it includes some areas in the background that I don't want included in the selection. Well, it's super simple. Just go to Window, create a window, and boom, right away, you don't have to worry anymore about those areas in the background because the window allows you to narrow down your selection. And of course, you can also use the tracker now, just like before, and the window will follow my face. And you can even add multiple windows if that's what you need. So combining windows with the qualifier tool, or the qualifier tool with windows, gives you a lot more control. And then the final technique that I want to show you, in this video at least, is something that only works in DaVinci Resolve Studio, Magic Mask. And I'm not going to do a detailed tutorial here on Magic Mask, I'll link that one in the description. But I just want to show you the possibilities. So in the color page, go to Magic Mask. And what you have to do then is just draw over an object or a person to make the mask. And this button here will show you the mask. And then just hit track and Resolve will create a selection, a mask of that object or person. And it's a dynamic mask, it moves. But the great thing is also here that you can easily combine the magic mask with either the qualifier tool or a window or both. So the possibilities and the control you have, well, it's incredible. Anyway, it's way too hot, I'm gonna stop here. I'm dying. Thank you so much for watching. Here, I'm gonna show you again. Yep, I'm wet. Thank you so much for watching. And see you in the next one.